In today's video, I will give another update on my Dividend Growth stock portfolio, including one new purchase, an update on the dividends that came in, and I shed some light on my portfolio strategy. Hi, this is Tom from The Dividend Attitude. I'm happy to announce that we have surpassed 350 subscribers, which is very nice. Again, thank you all to those who have subscribed, liked, and commented on my videos. Now on to my portfolio. My portfolio is divided throughout three brokers right now, with the plan to scale back to two brokers, which are Trading212 and DEGIRO. The plan I laid out last time was to move out my Bink Bank account completely straight away, but I came to realize that it probably bears less risk if I move over my portfolio in parts, because it will probably take a day before my funds are moved over to the new account with the withdrawal and everything. So if I miss a huge up day, then I won't be able to buy back as many shares as previously. My total portfolio now is at $10,161 and it is up 6.2% without dividends and 15.7% with dividends received. This is around the same amount as the portfolio update of August. However, now the total dividends received has surpassed the $900 mark, which is great. I actually did make the purchase I was talking about in the last portfolio update, which is General Dynamics. In short, I bought General Dynamics for a few reasons. Defense and aerospace is always needed, even in times like these, crisis times. GD is undervalued at the current price of 140 to 144. GD has a nice dividend growth rate of around 10%. It is a dividend aristocrat with 29 years of dividend raises under their belt. They have a growing revenue and net income. They have a healthy payout ratio. They have a lowish debt to equity ratio, above 0.5 but below 1.0. There are some risks I see with General Dynamics, which are a large portion of the revenue comes from government contracts. Risks with that are, if the approval process of the annual budget cycle of the US government is delayed, it can cause problems because certain projects have to wait for funding. GD could be hurt if a dovish government comes on that cuts back on defense spending. Changes in foreign US policies could hurt deals with international customers. I will talk a bit more about the actual purchase of General Dynamics when I show my Trading212 portfolio. So my portfolio now consists of 13 stocks over 7 different sectors. 3M, Bank First Corporation, Cisco, CVS, General Dynamics, Johnson & Johnson, Northwest Corporation, Omega Healthcare Investors, Qualcomm, Tensure Factory Outlets, T. Rowe Price, VF Corp, and Williams Sonoma. My biggest winners so far are Qualcomm with over a 100% gain, T. Rowe Price with 80%+ gain, and Williams Sonoma with an almost 75% gain. My biggest and only losers so far are Tensure Factory Outlets at almost minus 60%, CVS at almost minus 25%, and Northwestern at minus 16%. My focus, however, is on the income the portfolio generates, the dividends. More on that later. So why do I tell you about my biggest losers and winners? Because it perfectly illustrates why I focus on the long term and on the dividends. In the short term, anything can happen. But if you invest in quality companies with a proven track record, the dividends will keep coming in. Take Qualcomm and Williams Sonoma, for example. I have been in the red on Qualcomm for a long time and now it is my biggest winner. The same applies to Williams Sonoma. It has been up quite a bit but came down below my cost basis at the beginning of this crisis in March. And now is back up 75%. But in the meanwhile, dividends kept coming in and were increased. If you liked the video so far, don't forget to give the video a thumbs up and make it turn blue. Also, don't forget to subscribe if you want to stay updated on future content. In Trading212, I now have shares in Bank First and General Dynamics. I bought 2.2 shares of General Dynamics on the 5th of October for $142. So this is right on time to be eligible for the next dividend because the ex-dividend date is on the 8th of October. If you are confused about the different dates surrounding dividends such as ex-dividend date, the record date, the declaration and payout date, be sure to check out episode 3, now suggested in the top right corner, in which I explain all there is to know about dividends and the different dates. This brings my current portfolio value in Trading212 to €701. Later on, I will also discuss in a bit more detail what the purchase of General Dynamics means for my forward dividend income. My portfolio in Bink Bank now stands at about €6,900, which is up slightly since last month's review where it was at €6,823. Like I mentioned last time, the holdings in this broker will be transferred slowly to DEGIRO and Trading212. I didn't get around to doing it yet last month, but I will definitely start a process in the coming week. Right now it still holds the majority of my holdings, 9 out of 13. And then my portfolio in DEGIRO. In DEGIRO the value stands at €1,136. and I have 3M and Tensure Factory Outlets SKT in this portfolio. 3M is up about 12% since I purchased it, but SKT is still down significantly and will probably be for a while. I'm eagerly awaiting the earnings call for the latter on the 5th of November to see if perhaps the dividend might be reinstated. If they reinstate the dividend, I will consider purchasing a few shares to bring my cost basis down. The month of September brought me $24 in dividends. This is up 59% year on year, which mainly has to do with the purchase of 3M at the beginning of the year. Quarter over quarter there is no increase because no new purchases were made and there were no dividend increases. So it might look like a boring month and watching paint dry, but don't forget that I can use those $24 again to purchase new shares. Consider I deposit about $130 each month. That is almost 20% of a free deposit. I'm looking forward to the moment where that will become 100% of a free deposit, because that would be like making 13 deposits in a year instead of 12. Looking at the forward dividends, the purchase of General Dynamics will add $9.68 annual forward income to my dividend income stream, which now stands at $417. On an average basis, my portfolio will pay me almost $35 per month, $1.14 per day, and about $0.05 per hour. So that is an increase of $1 per month compared to last month. Again, all about the progress. Looking at the progress, with $275 received, I'm now a bit over half the way there towards the goal of $500 this year. Keeping the end goal, 30k annually, in mind, I'm now 1.39% of the way there. So an increase of 0.03% compared to last month. And then some about my future plans. If the price of GD stays around this level, I will buy more shares of GD. If GD really shoots up, I will put my funds elsewhere. One of those other candidates is Store Capital, which I did a comparison video about in episode 33 from last week. What I really like so far about Store Capital is their CEO, Christopher Volk. He has even written articles on Seeking Alpha, how he thinks about real estate and why he thinks the strategy of Store Capital by focusing on non-investment grade credit rated tenants will benefit them. I've never seen anything like this from a CEO who is writing on Seeking Alpha, so I'm quite intrigued. If you want to know more about Store Capital, be sure to check out that episode, which is now suggested in the top right corner. And then a little bit about my portfolio strategy. My portfolio strategy is quite simple. The focus is on companies that grow their dividends consistently year in and year out, and have done so for a while, at least 5 years. Besides the dividends, I also focus on the quality of the companies itself. Because without a growing profitable business, dividend payouts are not sustainable. So I focus on companies with growing revenue and net income trends long term, stable or expanding growth and operating margins, and low debt. Besides that, I also focus on more qualitative aspects such as management quality and companies that have a wide moat. If you want to learn more on how I find and research those companies, be sure to check out my playlist in which I go over all these different aspects. The playlist is now suggested in the top right corner. On a more macro level, I aim to build a portfolio of about 25 to 30 companies. Because I was reliant on brokers with higher fees before, this was done by saving up and then investing anywhere from 1.5 to 2k into it all at once into one stock. With me moving more towards trading 212, which has no fees and fractional shares, this has changed to a more gradual build up. If you are interested in starting a portfolio on trading 212, which is available to quite some EU countries, and you want to get a free share worth up to £100, euros or dollars, do check out the referral link in the description. Both you and me will get a free share if you successfully activate and fund your account. If you do, please let me know which free share you get so we can share the fun. I hope you enjoyed this portfolio update, and if you did, consider subscribing because I make portfolio updates every month. And besides that, I also create stock battle videos in which I analyze two similar companies to see which one performs better, and I also make in-depth dividend stock analysis videos. Until next time, bye bye.